मॉर्निंग सर।
Okay, good morning all of you. Am I audible?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Response me, am I audible or not?
Yes, sir.
Whatever.
Pranav, please tell me, am I audible or not?
Audible.
Okay. So just wait 1 minute, then I will start. Okay, so very good morning all of you. So let's start. So previous class I'm discuss the overview of the control system. Okay, so and last classes some problem is arise, this is due to network problem. So I just recall previous class and then also I am continue our syllabus oriented lectures. Okay, so this is your syllabus, that is the principle of control system. Okay, I think all of you seen this syllabus. Okay, so this is a theoretical subject and as well as also is present in lab also. Okay, so all of you know what is the control system. Okay, so anyone please tell me what is control system. Anyone? Okay, so what is control system? So this control, you have to easily, you have to tell that is anything you have to control, any system. Okay, that means you have to drive your car, you have to drive your cycle, you have to drive your bike as well as also. So you have to control this automobile or this bicycle, etc. So you have to control this overall process or overall system. That times you have to manage how it is working, how command you have to give in, it is working for the your criteria wise. Okay, so that means the definition of control system, a control system manage, commands, directs or regulates the behavior of other devices or system using the different control loops. Okay, so this is a basically control system. I repeat once again, a control system manage, commands, directs or regulates the behavior of other devices or systems, that is using by the different types of control loops or control actions. So this system, it is called the control system. Okay, so I just given you one example, that is you have to drive your car or cycle or motorcycle, that is you have to control the speed when you have to drive any automobile or any bike or car. So you have to control the overall process. That means how it is drive, how it is control the overall specifications, how it is speed is or acceleration is controlled by you. So you have to control these devices or systems. So this system, it is called the control system. Okay, it is okay, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So just we have to discuss at first, that is the what is the basically course outcome. So these are the basically course outcome, and we have to divide this principle of control system course outcome. This is CO1, CO2, CO3 and CO4. So first you have to learn, that is what the first outcome we have to learn, that is analyze the electromechanical system by mathematical modeling. That means there are different types of model we have to use, design the control systems or electromechanical systems. Electromechanical system, that means you have to drive a car. Okay, so in that case, this is the mechanical specification it is done, and also one electrical configuration is also present here. So this is electromechanical systems. So we have to first analyze the electromechanical system by the different types of mathematical modeling. Okay, number two, that is CO2, determine the transient response or determine transient response or of a system and steady state behavior of the system using the standard test signals. Okay, so we have to learn also, this is another outcomes, that is determine transient response and as well as also a steady state behavior response of a system using the standard test signals. Okay, so this is another important outcomes. Number three, that is CO3, we have to analyze the linear system for steady state error. Okay, so here are different types of error we have to discuss in our control systems. Okay, step by step. So we have to analyze the linear system for steady state response as well as absolute stability and relative stability using the time domain analysis, and another is frequency domain analysis. Analysis or technique, these are both same. Okay, so these are the basically course outcome of number three, that is analyze linear system for the steady state response and absolute stability and also relative stability using the time domain analysis and also frequency domain analysis. Okay, number four, CO4, that is a course outcome, that is outcome four, identify and design. Okay, so this is another one, identify and design control system satisfying specified requirements. Okay, so these are the basically course outcome we have learned throughout the semesters. Okay, and this is a COPO mapping. All of you will seen this is the basically course outcome and program outcomes is mappings here also. Okay, so here in this syllabus we have divided, that is five modules are present. Okay, so these are the basically the module 1, another one module 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, that is 6 module we have to design here. First one we have to learn, that is the introduction of the principle of the control system. So this is a basic portion of the control system. That means what is the control system, what is the classification of different types of systems, that is open loop and closed loop system. Then we have to discuss what is feedback system. Okay, so what is the need of feedback system? So thereafter, different types of feedback, that is classification of the feedback system, that is positive feedback and negative feedback, it is also present here. Then we have to learn that is mathematical modeling and representation of physical systems. Okay, and also this is physical system and analogous systems also we have to discuss in mathematical model in the first module. Then another important terms, that is a transfer functions. Okay, so this transfer function, it has different types of systems. Okay, so we have to learn the different types of transfer functions, how it is designed, okay, how it is resolved, that is how it is working. So we have to learn the transfer function equations also. Then block diagram deduction techniques. Okay, this is a block diagram, so we have to learn then block diagram reduction thing, how it is reduction. Reduction means that is a decreasing, that is one simple thing, a control system, there are lots of part, that is a lots of sections are present, that is controller part, that is a processing part, that is a feedback part, that is a set point part, that is input and output part. So these are the different types of parts are present here also. So in that case, when we have to discuss the transfer function and as well as also we have to decrease the block diagram reduction techniques, we have to learn in this module. Okay, then we have to discuss that is signal flow graph and as well as also machine gain formula. So this is the one formula, it is done and it is also helpful for the signal flow graph method. Okay, so this is a first module, introduction to principle of control systems. Okay, so is this clear all of you? Please response me anyone.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, thank you. So next module, these are the another term, that is time domain and frequency domain analysis. Okay, so this is a another important terms. So in this module we have to learn different time domain performance criteria of the steady state response or anything else is present. So in this case, when we have to design this any time domain analysis performance criteria, there are two types of systems we have to classify, that is first order system, another one is the second order systems. Okay, so we have to learn here. Then we have to discuss that steady state error or any and error constant of the different types of the system, that means first order system, second order system, there are different types of errors are present, we have to discuss that. Then dynamic error constants, then also we have to discuss that is derivation and its advantage and also disadvantage also, that is time domain and frequency domain, it has some advantages and also some little bit disadvantages also. So we have to learn here also. Then this is another important term, that is a controller part. Okay, so this controller part is very, very important, and some little bit experiment it is present in your lab syllabus. Okay, that is performance analysis for P, PI and PID controller. P means that is a proportional controller, then PI, that means the proportional integral controller, then PID, that means the proportional integral derivative controller. So this is a controller part we have to learn in this module, that is time domain analysis and as well as also frequency domain analysis. Okay, next module 3, this is a stability criteria. So in that module, here we have to learn stability operation of the any control systems. So in this module, there are different types of stability criteria we have to learn, that is concept of stability of the Rouse stability criteria. Then we have to learn stability analysis using the root locus method, Bode plot method. So these are the different types of method for the stability criteria. Okay, then we have to learn what is the absolute stability and relative stability. Okay, so I just telling that, so this control system, thereafter there are little bit that is some problem, that is a problem related topics are present there also. So we have to practice in class different types of problems also. Okay, so because in your exam, semester exams question, the problematic question, it is also coming your semester exams. Okay, so this is a basically stability criteria. And then here are another two topics are present, that is the definition of computation of gain margin and as well as also phase margins is also present. And also this is a comparison between the time and frequency response plot. So when you have to design, that is a gain margin and phase margin, thereafter two plots are responses here. One is time domain, that is a time response, and also another one is the frequency response. So we have to comparison between this time and frequency response in this stability criteria models. Then module 4 stability criteria continue. It has another part also. Thereafter another concept are present, which is clarify the stability operations of the stability actions of the control, different types of control systems. So this is a frequency response of polar plot methods and also its criteria, stability criteria. Then relative stability. Another one is the Nyquist criteria. Okay. So this polar plots criteria and Nyquist criteria, it has another types of method we have to use in the calculation of the stability criteria method. Okay. Then graphical representation or graphical approach for gain margin and phase margin using the polar plot. So this is a graphical one. Graphical problems are here also. We have to use the semi-log graph paper for the design of the gain margin and phase margin using the polar plot method. Then we have to discuss advantage and disadvantage of the frequency response of the plot in this module. Okay. Next, module 5. It is a little bit, that is a design purpose. Okay. So this is a compensation design. So compensation design, that means what is the compensation design? When you have to design any network means that is a control system networks. Okay, so in that case, three types of network we have to design, that is a lag network, lead network, and also lag lead network. So these three types of networks we have to draw the compensation design of any control systems. Okay, then compensation design of network using time domain analysis and as well as also frequency domain analysis. So these three types of networks, it is also working in the time domain analysis and as well as also frequency response analysis. Okay, so this is a compensation design. Okay, it is clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So last module, that is a state space analysis. So in this module, we have to learn different types of concept, that is state variable. Okay, that is a state space analysis, how it is working. Okay, what is the dynamic equations of this state space analysis? This is a one little bit something is concept here also. Okay, this is a dynamic equation and transient matrix also, and merits of the higher order differential equations and its solutions. And also we have to learn that is controllability and also observability. So this state space analysis, this is a basically control how it is control of the any control system or any behavior of the different types of control system. Okay, so this is a state space analysis. So this six modules are present in your syllabus. So here some reference book, that is a suggested books are present. So this is a very good book, that is a Nagraj Gopal. Okay, so when you have to collect the books from your library, you have to receive this book, that is a Nagraj Gopal, Control System Engineering. This is a very, very good. Okay. And another one is also present, that is a B.S. Manke, and it is also linear control system, that means the control systems. So please everyone write down or note down it. So these two books, very, very important, that is very, very necessary for your total coverage of your syllabus and both department, that is ECE and electrical. Okay, so this Nagraj Gopal, it is first preference. So then second is also linear control system. This is also B.S. Mankey, and this writer, this B.S. Mankey is not present here, but you have to note down it. Linear control system or control system engineering, these are the basically books names. A writer name is B.S. Mankey, and another one is the Nagraj Gopal control system. So these both books are available in your library, and also as well as it is also present in the internet also, that is a PDF also, so you have to download it also. And this another books is also, it is very good, okay, but these two books we have to follow basically, okay. And another one is the Hasan Sahib, that is a Hasan Sahib, this is the automatic control system. This book is very, very important, that is very good, very good book. So I did not know this book is available in your library or not, okay. So that's all in the related of the syllabus. So anyone, any doubt or any question, so please ask me. Anyone, any doubt or any questions or any clarifications, so please tell me. And one thing is, that is for everyone, please write your own name and class roll number, and who is the basically ECE department, so you have to written that within bracket, that is ECE, and who is the electrical department, it is also written in bracket is electrical, that is ECE. So everyone, I requested all of you, please everyone write your own name with class roll number, with your department, because it is a common class for ECE and ECE. So I did not track who is the ECE student and as well as also electrical student. And because this is a very important, because it is a note down for the attendance record also. And I am requested, that is, who is the Pranav? Pranav, you are the CR in electrical department?
Pranav, yes, sir.
Yes, Pranav, you take a screenshot and after ending the class, you have to send me my WhatsApp. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so anyone, any questions in this regarding for the syllabus, then you have to start the first topics. Okay, I think it is clear all of you. So we have started the syllabus also. So just wait, I am sharing my screen and then we have to continue. Okay, so my screen is visible. Anyone is response me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so let's start. So at first we have to start the introduction part of the control system. So all of you learned, all of you done, that is the, what is the control system. So this control system, it manage, that is a different types of commands or directs or regulates the behavior of the other devices or system using the different control loops. So this is called the control system. Okay, so all of you learned. So when I take another example, that means you have to control, that is you have to use this air conditioning machine in your rooms. Okay, so when the exterior temperature, that is outside of your room in temperature, it is high, so at this moment you have to on your air conditioning system in your rooms, then you have to control the temperature. Okay, So you have to control that. You have to control the temperature that is 22 degree or 24 degree, and anything it's else. That is the inside temperature, inside of the room temperature. It is decreased than the outside temperature. Okay. So you have to control the temperature. So this you have to uses. That is the remote. That is using this remote. You have to control. You have to. Given the command, or you have to given the anything is signals. Thus, these signals it is either wireless signals and as well as also wire signals. So in this case, in this example, in the air conditioning system, you have to use wireless remote. Something is commands. You have to given your air conditioning machine. That is, you have to decrease the temperature range. Then this machine, that is your air conditioning systems, so there are receiver circuit. So then this circuit, it is receive your signal, then decrease the temperatures, and this timing, that is this working timing, it is very very less. Okay, so when you have to control your remote control, and this signal it is sent by your remote to the air conditioning device. This device is detect the signals, then this machine it is working, that decrease the temperature. So this is a basically command or any directions or any regulation you have to given the devices or systems. Okay, within the anything is user, that is a control loop also. So this system it is called the control system. So in this picture here you can see this is a basically block diagram. You have to give in the input, and this input you have to give in a different system. It is also present, that is wireless system or with wired system also. Then this is a control system. This control system it is control the overall response. That is when you have to give in any input, then this control system it is process this the different types of input signals. Then this is process. Then you have to give in the result in the output section. Okay, so this is a basically one block diagram, that is a one representation of the control system. Okay, it is clear all of you? No one is response. So this is, please response anyone. It is clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. So here we have to use it. One example, another example, that is a traffic light control system. So everyone see in your town, in your nearest hometown or city. So you have to follow the traffic light control system. Okay. So when you have to crossing, that is a in that case traffic light system. There are three types of lights we have to see in that. That is one is red signal. That is a red light. Another one is the yellow signals or yellow light. Another one is the green signal or green light. So each and every light or signals, it is working in the timing domain. That is, the timing is given here. So you have to set the particular timing. That means when it is red signal, it is on. That is, red light is on. That means this road is in that time given. That time. It is closed. So you have to set the 60 second. That is a 1 minute. So during this time, this road it is not permissible any automobile or any persons. Okay. So then after 60 second or after 1 minute, this red light it is also send the signal in the yellow light. That is yellow signals. You have to given the timing or 5 second or 10 second. That means you have to tell in that time, this 5 second or 10 second, you have to ready to move here to another direction. Then after 5 or 10 second, I have till the 5 second or 10 second, because it is dependent on the city traffic or any town traffic department, that is a traffic loading systems. So you have to seen in the Ranchi, there is a hometown, that is a your mega metro city of the Jharkhand state or Kolkata. Here you can see there are different types of timing setup for controlling the different timing. Then after these yellow signals, we have to glow the green light or green signal. So when this green signal it is glow, that means this road is open. So at that time you have to move this person, that is that this road is open. So you have to going one side to another side. So this is a basically control system, that is the applications also. So this traffic light control system, it is a example of control system. He had a sequence of input signals. It applied to this control system, and the output is one of the three lights. That's why we have to tell that it's three types of lights are present. So that will be the on for some duration of the time. I am telling that. So here we have to setting the different types of duration of time. So during this time, the other two lights will be also off. Based on the traffic study at a particular junctions and the on and off time of the lights can be determined. Accordingly, this input signal, it controls the output signals also, and this traffic lights control system, it operates on the time basis. I am telling that without timing signals or without time setting time, this traffic light is not working properly. Okay. Another one, it is also present, example, washing machine. So all of you seen this washing machine or uses washing machine. So when you have to use this washing machine, you have to control outside, that is with the help of remote control or with the help of different types of knobs or switches are present. So you have to controlling the speed of the motor armature, that is a when it is rotated, okay. Or anything else, you have to comment this down. That is your washing your shirts or pants or anything else. That is, you have to setting the particular time. The 30 minutes, it is also washable. Then this after 30 minutes, it is also one signal that you have to given. That is one alarm or buzzer. It is also sounds its outgoing. Then this system, it is also working in the automatic. Okay, so this washing machine, it is also working in the semi-automatic, and another one is the automatic system. So this is basically the examples of the any control systems. So I think it is clear. Anyone any so question, so please ask me. Anyone any doubt or any question, so please ask me. Okay, so I think all of you know, today we have two classes. So after ending these classes, everyone please join after 5 to 7 minutes also. Okay, I am also given one message in your WhatsApp group, then you have to also join. Okay, because we have two classes today. Next, basically, what is the classification of the control system? So this control system, its classification, it is also different oriented. So in your syllabus, only it is also done for the two type, that is a closed loop control system, another one is the open loop control system. So based on the parameters, we can classify the control system in the different categories. First one, here you can see, this is a basically time and discrete time, that is a continuous time and discrete time. These are the basically two control system with respect to the timing oriented. That means first one, this control system, it can be classified as continuous time control system and discrete time control system. So the example of that is a traffic signal. Yes. Anyone any questions? So please ask me. Otherwise mute yourself. Okay. So this is a basically control or continuous timing signals. Another one is the discrete timing signal. Discrete, that means that when you have to select the one by one, that is you have to given something time is given, then it is off condition, then another one it is also opening or ongoing process. So this is a discrete timing. So this, and in continuous time control system, all the signals are continuous in time or discrete timing control system, there exist one or more discrete timing signals. So according to timing, we have to classify the control system in two categories. Sorry, first one is the continuous time signals, another one is the discrete timing control system. Okay. Next category, number two, that is CISO and MIMO. So please everyone note down it, CISO and MIMO control system. CISO means that is single in, single out. MIMO means multiple in, multiple out control system. Okay, so this CISO and MIMO. Dichika Singh, Dichika Singh, any questions or mute yourself? Okay, so this CISO and MIMO control system, CISO means that is a single input and single output control system. Another one is the MIMO, that means the multiple inputs, multiple output control system. Okay, so this control system, it can be classified as CISO control system and the MIMO control system, the based on the number of inputs and output. Number of inputs, that means when you have to given any input in single or output is received from the output section in the single. So this is called the CISO, that means the single input, single output systems. Okay. Another one is the MIMO. That means when you have to receive, when you have to given the any multiple inputs. Okay. And that means you have to given the two or more inputs at a time. And then you have to receive the output from the output section in the multiple format. So this is this system, it is called the MIMO control system. MIMO, that means the multiple input, multiple output control systems. Okay. Next, another one, this is the important thing, that is the classifications of the control system, that is the open loop control system and closed loop control systems. Okay, so this open loop and control loop, open loop and closed loop control system, it is classified based on the feedback path. So according to the feedback loop or feedback path, this is also classified into two categories. One is the open loop control system, another one is the closed loop control system. So here you can see this is a one block diagram of the open loop control system. Okay, so here you can see this is the input sections where you have to given the input, something like that. You have to given anything is input. This input is physically input you have to given, or any digitally input, that is 0-1 concept you have to given. Okay, then next block, it is a controller part, which is control the overall actions, or which is control the overall process of the control systems. So this is the controller which is received from the input from you or something like that, machines. Okay, then this controller process this input and given the output through the actuating signals to the plant. Plant means where the process is working. Plant means that is, you have to know different types of industries are present. There is a petrochemical industries, gaseous industries, medical lab industries, okay, food and beverage industries, drinks, that is a drinking water or any cold drinks industries, anything like that. So this is a plant. So when an engineer or when a worker, it's given any input to the process of the any control systems, so you have to give in the controller part. Then this controller part process the actuating signal, particularly you have to given or user is given. Then this plant, it is processed by the actuating signal. Then this plant, it is given the output from the output sections. Okay, so this is called the open loop control system. So after ending the class, so everyone please join another class we have to present after 5 to 7 minutes. I am giving the message in your WhatsApp group. So this is a open loop control system. So in that case, there are no feedback loops.